Whether your house is big or small, everyone wants to maximize their storage. We're gonna tackle the basic bedroom closet and how to really max out that space. Here's our standard setup. We've got an average size bedroom closet. We've just taken the double doors off so you can see right into it. But let's say it's got 8-foot ceilings and it's maybe 8 to 10 feet wide. Usually on day one when you move in, you've got a single hanging rod, which is great. But probably 95% of your wardrobe is not full-length ball gowns, so we're really not using that space effectively. My recommendation, if you're not going to invest a lot and change the whole thing out, is why don't you leave yourself a little bit of long hanging and then bring in a dresser or a cubby for some shoes and install a tension rod between there and the far wall. That way you're gonna get double hanging for most of the space. So for this dresser, you can either use it for everyday things, underwear and socks, or it can be out of season stuff that you want to keep out of your main space. If you've got a little bit more money to spend on the closet without really increasing the square footage, you can do something a little more sophisticated. I would still recommend giving yourself a little bit of long hanging, but don't go crazy. Like about a foot should probably be more than enough. And then you can either put in a system, panel, or you can continue that long rod straight across, and then give yourself something to tie in a lower rod as well. If you think about the outfits that you wear, you basically have longer stuff on the top, and then you can take your pants and fold them and they become a short hanging item, or it might be a skirt or a pair of shorts. So the upper rod needs a little bit more space than the lower rod, which gives us the ability to maybe do some shoe shelves below. Your upper rod is gonna be within easy reach, which means you've probably got space above for a shelf. Up there, you can be putting things like baskets with out of season items or guest linens. Baskets higher up are great for infrequently used items, like Halloween costumes, those cat vests your grandmother gives you, fedoras, whatever you're not gonna use every day. The average hanger and the average person is about 18 inches side to side. Now, you want to leave enough space to have some bulkier clothing on the outsides. So I would always hang my rod a minimum of 10 inches from the back of my closet. That means that 20 inches is the absolute minimum interior size for a bedroom closet. If I were designing a front hall closet, I would really want to go with 22 to 24 inches because you're going to have bigger parkas and coats because, hey, we live in Canada. So we're hanging our rods 10 inches from the back wall. But now, how high do we want to go off the floor? An average recommendation for a taller rod would be 72 inches off the ground. That's going to give you enough space for a long dress or a full-length winter coat. For your upper rod, if you're hanging double, you want to leave 42 inches for things like shorter dresses, men's sports coats, and long dress shirts. The recommended height for a lower hanging rod would be a minimum of 26, but I prefer to go with 30. I think it just gives you enough space for pants folded over a hanger or a longer skirt. If you're planning on including shoe shelves, you're gonna wanna cheat all of that up by 6 to 9 inches per shelf so that you're getting all those clearances off the ground. There are lots of bells and whistles you can add to really kit out your closet if you want to. You can get a light that's underneath your rod and it lights your clothing beautifully. But if I had to pick one, the luxe touch I would go with is something called a valet rod. It mounts pointing outward and allows you to display one chosen outfit sort of facing you, and you can inspect it for stains, you can steam it while it's there, you can set up your outfit for the next day with your accessories and your shoes. It's just a really nice way to, you know, set up an outfit. Remember, when you're looking for storage opportunities, your closet isn't the only space. Think about other places like getting a bed that's got built-in storage, or you can get trundle Rubbermaids that slide underneath your bed frame. Another option I always like to do is to do a small dresser rather than a proper nightside table, because that's going to give you a lot of storage. A clever closet system is one that's a mix of solutions that suit what you own. If you have nothing but boots and ball gowns, you'll need something different from someone who lives in suits.